stand by for action.
Thanks for joining me. My name is Dave Milner. I am the Unpleasant Blind Guy, and I want to welcome you to part three of this episode of the Unpleasant Blind Guy on EDL Radio. Now remember, if you want to contact me with comments, questions, show suggestions, Awesome American suggestions, I'm available at UBGContact on Twitter, or I can also be found as Dave Milner or Agador, that's A-G-G-E-D-O-R, on Mublet, the Tea Party Community, Spreely, Minds, MeWe, or Gab. Now let's begin.
And there it is. What strikes me, Jeff, about all this is, aside from the just the horrible loss of life and everything, man, is the way that the media has treated it. Only people like ourselves, Bare Naked Islam, the Religion of Peace, Breitbart, some of the others, some of the more conservative media have given this nearly the coverage that it deserves while it was going on. And the mainstream media was almost nowhere to be seen. They were too busy covering, you know, idiocy, for instance, involving President Trump and other things of that nature. And again, Jeff, if all of these attacks that we're hearing about had been attacks on Muslims by Christians or even Sikhs, I think the media would still be talking about it. It would be just wall to wall coverage. But with this, practically crickets. And just the horror of what we're hearing here, families attacked, cities with Christians in them being attacked with rockets because they're Christian cities, church services being interrupted with attacks, things of that nature, Jeff. That sort of thing, no, that doesn't get covered by the fake stream media because they're afraid it will make Islam look bad. Am I right or am I right?
Well, they just get you bang on, Dave. Also, they're just too scared. They're all cowards. They don't want to report on the truth. It's people like us who go out of the way, and Breitbart, and many other of the great people out there who is going out of their comfort zones and speaking out. Even though you come under intimidation, I've seen it over the last couple of days.
Sure.
Of intimidation with the Muslims. You see, some people are willing to walk the walk and do the talk, except, you know what I'm saying? You know, you
sure.
Look at people like Tommy Bobbitt, you look at people like the EDL, always have gone out of their comfort zones. You know, and they throw everything they can at us, but we're still here because we are on the right side of history. I look at it that way. We're on the right side. And all these people that chuck up these aspersions about what we do is because they're all traitors, dimmies, and appeasers, collaborators. You can call them that because we are at war. This is war. What you're hearing is war. This death cult has declared war. They've been built. Well, it's not declared. It's been an ongoing continuation of a 1400-year war, isn't it, Dave? You know,
yes,
there's no break
right, yeah.
from it until it's eradicated.
No.
Someone's got to be brave enough to stand up and take it on and take it out. You want peace in this world? You're never going to have peace all the time. This death cult exists. Call me what you like. Call me, oh, we call it for chance. No. I'm just calling to eradicate evil in the world. I don't think I'm wrong in saying that. To have peace in our time, we're never going to have it with this death cult roaming. And they're on a rampage now, aren't they? They're just stepping it up. You've heard, ladies and gentlemen. You've heard.
Mm-hmm.
This isn't a so-called peaceful religion. They say, oh, Islam, religion of peace. And they smile at you. when they're thinking about opening your throat or raping your wife or your children. The trouble is people are too stuck in their ways with their heads in the sand. They still, the apathy out there makes you cringe, doesn't it, brother? You know what I'm saying. It's the apathy. The whole
yeah,
thing
it's
about
true.
It.
It's true, Jeff. Yeah, it's an apathy, and actually doing something about Islam would take an effort on almost everyone's part, and they don't want to go through with the effort. They think that it's just as easy to let it continue, and they don't want to even look at the lives that are being destroyed.
Would you say it's like a cultural suicide? They're committing cultural suicide. Oh, people that wants to
certainly.
Do something, who wants to stand up and defend what's right, are being defamed as knuckle druggers, like we've been in the EDL, like Tommy, you know, having all these things thrown up against him. All these names that they call us, trying to defame, deplatform people, just to shut us up, so they can let this bloody cult steam through, take over, murder everything in sight, and then be murdered themselves. These Muppets don't really understand, but they think they're going to get away with it, Dave. You know, because they're not doing a fight. I will stand side by side, be fighting with you as well. Yeah, but when it comes to a quiet time, don't you think you're going to be on the block? Because they bloody will. You are still Kufar. You are still infidel to them. Whether you like it or not, you will go down with your head missing. That's all there is to it.
Well, they'll join up or
because it needs to be told.
No,
people are too stupid out there.
Yeah,
you know,
you're right.
Winston Churchill said it's so true. So much was done by so few. We are the so few. All you patriots out there, and I know you're listening to the show, it's people like you, the people that put their lives on the line and to do it for people who hide under the tables, who call your names over the internet, who dox you, and things like that, trying to bring death on your doorstep. But you still do it. Because you're patriots, because you love your country. You love your brother, you love your sister. But that's what it's about. In the end, people have got to wake up. This is an evil cult. It needs to be dealt with. Stop sitting on your backside. Do something. If I was young enough, don't you think I'd be out there? Don't you think I'd be doing it? There's a lot of younger people out there listening. I hope you're listening, guys, because the time is now. The time for all this sitting there and talking in the pub about, oh, it's so bad. Get off your arses and join the fight with us. It's your time now. You know, some of us now, I'm too old to fight now. It's down to you. Down to you.
Yeah,
no,
that's
to,
true.
I'm sorry, listeners.
It's all good, Jeff. Yeah.
But I've got to tell you the way it is, guys. It's really that bad now. Look at the rape that's been going on in this country. There's going to be a documentary coming out very, very soon. You will see this, and it will shake you to the bone. I guarantee you. The rape of Britain.
Well,
you wait till you see it.
Yeah. That's true, Jeff. And I want to say from my part, and no, this is not the EDL position. This is my part, the unpleasant blind guy, and people can call me what they want. I honestly don't care. You know, I don't want to see any Islam, you know, anyone, Muhammad or whatever, killed or anything of that nature. But I do want Islam out of the civilized world. Okay, if Mohammedans want to be in predominantly Islamic countries and do their thing there, then that's fine with me. You know, we can do us, they can do them. You know, but it's obvious that Islam does not mesh with the civilized world, Jeff. It doesn't mesh with the UK, the US. As we heard in the last audio, it doesn't mesh with France. And as we're going to hear in this final audio, okay, that covers the 27th of May through the 4th of June, they can't even be peaceful with each other. It's this animalistic violence that Islam whips up in people. As Dr. Nikolai Sinels wrote, Islam creates monsters. Jeff, if you're ready, I'll go ahead and run this final audio from Breitbart, this Breitbart article.
Yeah, Yeah, and it's been great the so far day. Breitbart, you do absolutely awesome work,
yeah.
Brothers. We're really proud of what you do. Thank goodness for people like you are out of your comfort zone. You're speaking these facts. Good on you. God bless you all. Go on, Dave. Continue, brother.
All right, I will. Now, you guys are listening to the English Defense League radio show, and if you're listening to this in the month of July, obviously you're listening to the Unpleasant Blind Guy on EDL Radio, and that's on shrmedia.com, and the English Defense League radio show, if you're listening there on shrmedia.com through Spreaker, the English Defense League radio show is available at blogtalkradio.com. Thursdays and Sundays at 3:30 p.m. Eastern in the United States. We're going to continue with part four of this article from Breitbart.com. This is EDL Radio. Here we go, guys. This is the last part in about 10 minutes.
May 27th, Balkh, Afghanistan. Taliban kills three pro-Kabul militiamen, wounds another in Zari district. May 27th, Badghis, Afghanistan. Taliban kills four pro-Kabul militiamen, including commander, in Al-Inaw region. May 27, Saraipul, Afghanistan. Taliban kills eight ANSF members, wounds 29 others, and captures three at the Kashgari military base in the provincial capital. May 27, Ghor, Afghanistan. Taliban kills two pro-Kabul militiamen, wounds two others in provincial capital. May 27, Badakhshan, Afghanistan. Unknown jihadis bomb strikes Afghan military vehicle, killing one soldier, wounding two others in Arganqua district. May 27, Kunduz, Afghanistan. Taliban kills three pro-Kabul militiamen, two soldiers, and also captures three militiamen, three civilians in Khan Abad district. May 27, Samangan, Afghanistan. Taliban kills one police officer and wounds another in the provincial capital. May 27, Saraipul, Afghanistan. Taliban kills one local police officer in Suzma-Ala district. May 27, Logar, Afghanistan. Taliban kills five soldiers, wounds four, captures four others, and steals Humvee at army checkpoint in Baraki Barak district. May 27, Ghor, Afghanistan. Taliban kills 18 Afghan security forces, including 15 pro-Kabul militiamen and three police officers who were clearing the area of terrorists so workers could fix UNESCO World Heritage Site damaged by flash floods in Shirak District. May 27, Borno, Nigeria, Boko Haram kills 7, wounds 2, including members of civilian task force, and steal food in Jari region. May 27, Kashmir, India. Suspected Hizbul Mujahideen kills civilian in Handwara town. May 27, Pattani, Thailand. Suspected Islamic terrorists kill two, including 14-year-old, wound four troops in a marketplace bombing in Nong Chik district. May 27, Mount Lebanon, Lebanon. Hezbollah narco-terrorists kill innocent bystander when reportedly retaliating to attack on a mosque in Christian town of Damor in Shu district. May 27, Cabo Delgado, Mozambique. Suspected Islamists kill 16 civilians, wound 10 others in Macomia. May 28, Ghazni, Afghanistan. Taliban kills Afghan military prosecutor and a government official. May 28, Ghor, Afghanistan. Taliban kills 18 in the provincial capital, including 13 civilians, and wounds 17 others. May 28, Khost, Afghanistan. Taliban kills 13 soldiers, wounds 10 others in Sabari district. May 28, Samangan, Afghanistan. Taliban kills 5 soldiers, 1 police officer and wounds 3 police officers in Dar-i-Sufpan district. May 28, Wardak, Afghanistan. Sunni Taliban-linked insider attack leaves 9 police officers of Shiite Hazara ethnicity and the bodyguard of the governor of a nearby province dead. May 28, Hama, Syria, Al-Qaeda-linked HTS fires rockets into several regime-held towns killing one woman, injuring 7 other civilians. May 29, Baghlan, Afghanistan, Taliban kills 6 soldiers and wounds 4 others in the provincial capital. May 29, Khost, Afghanistan, unknown terrorist bomb hits civilian vehicle, killing 1 and wounding 5 others, including women and children. May 29, Khost, Afghanistan, unknown terrorists kill tribal elder and former director of the Ministry of Refugees and Repatriation in a mosque near his home in the provincial capital. May 29, Kabul, Afghanistan, unknown terrorists kill 1 police officer at outpost in nation's capital where Taliban and ISIS are known to operate. May 30, Kirkuk, Iraq, ISIS jihadis kill 1 villager, wound 7 others in Dak district. May 30, Kabul, Afghanistan, ISIS suicide bomber kills 6 people and wounds 16 others when he blew himself outside military academy. May 30, Balkh, Afghanistan, Taliban kills 7 pro-Kabul militiamen, wounds 8 others in Dalat Abad district. May 30, Babgis, Afghanistan, Taliban kills 16 Afghan commandos, wounds 15 others in Balamargab district. May 30, Jozjan, Afghanistan, Taliban kills 4 pro-Kabul militiamen in Karkin district. May 30, Faryab, Afghanistan, Taliban kills 13 soldiers, 1 pro-Kabul militiaman, wounds 3, and capture 2 others in Khoistan district. May 30, Kunduz, Afghanistan, Taliban kills 1 local police officer, wounds 5, including 2 police officers and 3 soldiers. May 30, Jozjan, Afghanistan, Taliban kills 2 police officers, 1 civilian, and wounds another civilian. May 30, Diyala, Iraq, ISIS kills 1 villager, wounds 7 others, sets fire to their farms. May 30, Kirkuk, Iraq, ISIS kills policeman, wounds another in town of Abu Sa'ida. May 31, Kabul, Afghanistan, Taliban attacks U.S. convoy, killing 4 Afghan civilians, injuring 4 American troops. May 31, Sulu, Philippines, ISIS-linked Abu Sayyaf jihadis kill Dutch hostage as he tried to escape from mountain village near town of Patikul. May 31, Jerusalem, Israel, Palestinian terrorist wounds 2 in stabbing. June 1, Ghazni, Afghanistan, Taliban kills 8 police officers, wounds 7 in provincial capital. June 1, Borno, Nigeria, Boko Haram kills worshipper, wounds 3 others inside mosque in Sajeri village near state capital. June 1, North Waziristan, Pakistan, Islamic terrorist kills 1 soldier with bomb in Boya area. June 1, Raqqa, Syria, suspected ISIS suicide bomber kills 10, wounds 20 in group's former capital. June 1, Hadhramut, Yemen, Al-Qaeda jihadis attack Saudi-backed militia checkpoint, killing at least 1 fighter, wounding 2 others. June 1, Diyala, Iraq, suspected ISIS terrorists kill 3 family members, including man and his son near town of Abu Sa'ida. June 1, Anbar, Iraq, suspected jihadis kill 9 civilians by setting them ablaze while they were looking for truffles in Malasha area. June 2, Narathi Wat, Thailand, suspected Islamic insurgents kill 1 village head inside mosque in Ranji district, injure praying man. June 2, Kabul, Afghanistan, ISIS targets university bus, killing 2 and wounding 24, including 2 reporters. June 2, Farah, Afghanistan, Taliban kills 6 border security forces, wound 8 others guarding country's boundary with terrorist group ally Iran. June 2, Aleppo Province, Syria, Islamic terrorist suicide car bomb kills 22, including 5 children and 2 women, wounds more than 20 near mosque in Assas region. June 3, Kabul, Afghanistan, unknown terrorists target bus carrying government employees, killing 5, wounding 10 in capital where both ISIS and Taliban operate. June 3, Kashmir, India, unknown terrorists kill civilian in Pantha Chowk area in the outskirts of Srinagar city. June 3, Tripoli, Lebanon, ISIS-linked suicide bomber kills 2 police, 2 soldiers. June 3, Mandera, Kenya, suspected Al-Shabaab jihadis kills 2 security forces. June 4, Baghlan, Afghanistan, unknown terrorists bomb detonated near mosque in Naran district, killing 2 civilians, wounding 14 others. June 4th, North Kivu, Democratic Republic of Congo, DRC, ISIS kills 13 civilians, wounds 12 others in Beni region. June 4th, the Yala, Iraq, ISIS wounds 2 soldiers at army checkpoint in Beni Zaid village. June 4th, Salahuddin, Iraq, suspected ISIS jihadis kill 6 security forces in Al Tarmiya district. June 4th, Dara, Syria, unknown terrorists kill 1 and wound 2 civilians near mosque in Bisr al-Harir city. June 4th, Al Bayda, Yemen, Shiite Houthi rebels kill Imam, 9 worshippers at a mosque in the Kafa district over a dispute at the start of Eid al-Fitr, the holiday that marks the end of Ramadan.
There you are, Jeff and listeners. Yes, even in an argument over when one holiday starts and another one ends, quote-unquote holiday, they're willing to kill. This is the true face of Islam.
Kill, 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 murder, kill, kill. That's it's what it's about. It's what it's about.
Mm-hmm.
When you try to actually, if you engage with any Muslims, they've got nothing to offer to defend this death cult of theirs. Nothing. I know. I've been there. I've done it. There's nothing that they can do to defend this. It is a challenge for the world that we've been put in front of us with over 1,400 years. Was this, is this a type of a penance that the human race has got to pay, that we've got to once again come to the fray and take on this evil? And that's what it is, guys. It's nothing but pure evil. If you go into a village and you set people alight just for the fun of it, and watch people burn to death, and you get glee out of doing that.
Mm-hmm.
You haven't got no soul. Well, these people haven't no souls. Let's see, that's the whole thing about it, isn't it, though? They have no souls. They're born and bred to kill the infidel, the kuffar, for their cult.
That's certainly it. Islam does that.
Why do you
think that they
pray to the and worship a moon gods? So I mean, reflect on this. Every time you see a Muslim bowing down and he hits his head on the ground, how many times a day? 5 times a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. And the people say, why did they come across as stupid? Of course they're bloody stupid. They read that horrible book. They bow and pray to Satan, because that's what they do. The way to worship isn't with your head on the floor. It isn't, is it, Dave? It's not the way. You're praying to a satanic cult. The moon god. Who do you think the moon god is? Satan. But don't forget, Allah, when they say Allah, Allah was one of 316 gods of theirs out there. He was chosen by Muhammad as his god. Right? That's what he's done. He chose one of them, and because he liked them to represent the moon. It was a moon god. And when they cry out, Allah Akbar, they're really calling out Satan. When they say Akbar, and I'll tell you this now, I ain't getting no bull crap or anything like that, but Akbar is an old Hebrew name. Check it out yourself, guys. It's an old Hebrew name for large rodent. It's a Hebrew name. It's a really old, ancient name. But that's where it comes from. Every time they go Allah Akbar when they're killing people or on the rampage, just remember what they're saying. Satan is a rodent. It's a large rodent. You see, does it make bloody sense, Dave? It's cold in It's just a mate. Anyway, all of it is just plagiarised. What he done is he put things together He took bits out of the Old Testament and the New, mixed them, botched them together. And if you read the Quran, everything is out of context. And you know why? Because a lot of their translations, what they did was lost in their jihad battles. A lot of their clerics was killed in jihad battles. You want to read up about it, how many times they had to rewrite that book. And they could only, and there was one actually session, Dave, that it's supposed to be a donkey ate half of a crane. And and when you speak to them, oh, no, we remember it. You know, it's like, Dave, if I tell you a story, right, if I tell you a joke,
right.
I guarantee you tell your friend a joke. You tell your friend tells your friend a joke. Before it's finished, it's changed the whole context of the story, isn't it? The joke.
Well, certainly.
It end up as a joke in the end, and that is exactly how their so-called Quran that they've said was given to them by God. They're God. And this prophet is supposed to have a coming together with this angel in a cave. Why would he come into a cave? Where was the witnesses to prove that case? There was none. Just his word. He was prodding a chest. Learn. And he goes, what have I been? He said, learn. You know, he just didn't have a clue. As we know, Salman Rushdie spoke about the, which ones was it, Dave? The satanic verses. Ladies and gentlemen,
yes.
Just to give you, you can read the satanic verses because I'll tell you what, it's really interesting. But when you come to the conclusion, for 13 months of his life, and this is what he said, this is why the verses were removed, that he said, Muhammad, their so-called prophet, said he was possessed by Satan in 13 months. But when he looked at it and he wrote it down, oh my goodness me, there was a problem. Would people listen to someone who's been who's possessed by Satan for 13 months? No. So why do you think the verses were removed? And Salman Rushdie was spot on. Why do you think he's still in hiding? Why do you think he's never showed his face? Because he exposed this death cult for what it's all about, ladies and gentlemen. But Dave, did you want to comment out? I've gone over a little bit of history about this person.
Yeah, just a little bit, yeah, Jeff. You know, but I mean, what I'll do is thank everybody for listening to this. And folks, this is a show you may want to share. You may want to share this show out to your friends and your contacts using your social media because they probably don't know the full extent or any real details of what went on during this Ramadan time. And as Jeff says, you know, it does sound like a nasty war because that's what it is. And Jeff, I'm going to go ahead and give my final thoughts so we can shut the show down.
Can't hold him down, you know. He's always on the move, Davis. Guys, Agador, that's your brother.
Please check out The Unpleasant Blind Guy at Spreaker.com. That's under SHR Media there. And that is also available on YouTube under SHR Media. The show times are 1 p.m. Monday through Friday Eastern in the United States, and that's 6 p.m. BST, British Summer Time in the U.K., and, of course, Saturday at midnight Eastern in the States and at 5 a.m. in the U.K. And right now, I'm running shows that won't all be this way, but most of them are going to be Jeff and me doing these shows in little bite-sized bits each day of some of the older English Defense League radio shows. So if you don't catch it here at blogtalkradio.com, you know, go to Spreaker and check it out there. And, of course, on the Western Free Radio Network, as I said. As I say, Jeff, it's been a good show. I want to thank you for allowing me to come in here and participate in everything, as always. Jan, on assignment out there.
My honor and a pleasure to have you,
brother. Yeah, love you, Jan. And want to say to the foot soldiers, angels, Brexiteers, and patriots of the EDL and global patriots out there, everyone be prosperous and be blessed and no surrender. Back to you, Jeff.
No surrender ever, Dave. No, thank you, Dave. As I say, the show's just like a blur tonight. Started off with a few technical problems. I didn't realise my internet, I needed to reboot my router at the beginning. But we soon come to terms with exactly what was going on. Now, I'd like to thank Dave for all the great clips tonight. The slides, the slides and the scripting this evening. As well, Dave. Great script, by the way. And of course, throughout Jan, she's always a busy lady. And you know, it's always lovely when we're all together as a team. And it was lovely that Jan joined us for that special week of ours, wasn't it, Dave? It was really great to see us back speaking, doing our thing.
D-Day
but
special,
once again,
yes.
I've got to thank everybody out there. Whatever devices you listen, and we know you catch us a lot on our podcast or even on the website. Don't forget www.englishfansleague.org.uk. It's the website. If you go down there, you'll see the radio show there. Click on it, and away you go. You can hear me and Dave on there, so you don't have to mess about too much. And Jan, even, you know, but we every time we do a show, within a little time, once it's been processed, it will appear on the English Defence League website. So there you go. If you want a little more bites of listening to the shows, if you like my rants and Dave with his doing his thing as well, there you go. There's different places. And also, you can find myself. I'm a moving target now, Dave, as you know. I still got Facebook, but I don't have another account. But I've lost all the other pages I used to have. So all my followers out there, or my supporters and all that, unfortunately, I lost that. But I've moved over to Gab, Mother MeWe, Mother Minds, and there's a couple of other ones that are in the proceeds of setting things up. So if you want to find me at all, just flick around, right? I'll tell you what, if you want to find me on Gab, just look at Nighthawk 777. There you go, at Nighthawk 777. You'll find me there. And that is the same with MeWe, isn't it, Dave? I'm the same with MeWe as well. At Nighthawk 777. And that's me. Just remember, that's Jeff. But once again, thank you all. And our guest has been here all this evening. He sat with us, or she sat with us, I'm not quite sure. But that number does look quite familiar. But I've got to thank you for joining us in the studio. It's always nice to see our guests sit with us and listen to the show in the studio, isn't it, Doug? Isn't it lovely? So thanks a lot for joining us this evening. So once again, coming down to the end of the show. We're not. I've still got a few minutes, but it's nice to play the tune out as we normally do, isn't it, Dave? Without it cutting off in the middle. So to everybody out there, be careful out there, guys. Be careful out there. Next couple of weeks or so, on the 29th, St. Big's going to happen in London. The veterans are gathering. There's a gathering in a part of London. And there'll be a gathering, but they're not just going to do a straightforward demonstration. They'll be camping there. So things need to be changed. And this is a soldier. So you can check it out, actually. You want to find out what's going on, because there's a lot going on in the UK. So with that, from myself, from Dave, from everybody associated with the radio show, and, of course, the great organisation, don't forget, check it out. And we've got also a donate page, please. If you can afford anything, just a couple of quid here or a couple of dollars there, well, whatever you can afford, it helps the fight continue. It helps us keep doing what we do. Okay, guys? So we really, really do appreciate it. And if you have donated, I'd like to thank you for Bob Nyhart, and so with David, so everybody associated with the English Defence League organisation. So cheers, guys, and our media team out there, great job as usual, doing all the great works you do. And so for myself and Dave, good night, God bless, take care, stay safe, and be vigilant out there. And for myself and Dave, no surrender, no surrender ever. And guess what? Guess what? We are going underground. Good night, everybody.
Good night, Jeff.
Oh, yes, I managed to play the tune out this evening. So thank you, everybody, for taking part of this show this evening, listening in on your different devices, wherever you might be, whatever part of the world you might be. We really appreciate it, because, as I'll say, if it wasn't you, there wouldn't be us. So thank you, everybody. So that's it. This is going to close the show out now. So once again, this... it's the English Defence League radio show signing off for tonight, but we'll be back again Sunday. So, yeah, take care, stay safe, God bless you, and no surrender ever. Good night, everybody. Good night, Dave. Good night, our guests there. Good night, all. See you Sunday.
And that is it for this time. I appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you for listening, and may your God go with you. Goodbye. The Unpleasant Blind Guy is copyright 2019. Anno Domini. Now for Dave's Canes. Extras that help you navigate the new media world.
Conservative media done right. You're listening to the SHR Media Network.
Hey, this is Michael Wright.
And I'm Shannon Wright.
Join us for The Right Way with Shannon and Mike, Monday through Thursday from 7 to 9 a.m. right here on SHR Media.
Why are they joining us?
For fun things like sports, politics.
Oh, maybe some news and entertainment?
And all kinds of other things.
Money and recipes and events, all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, so join us Monday through Thursday, 7 to 9 a.m. here on SHRmedia.com.
From a public locker inside a dilapidated Long Island rail station comes a show designed to piss off liberals using truth, facts, and ridicule. The Lid Radio Show, featuring the conservative voice from the People's Republic of New York, the Lid himself, Jeff Dunnitz. Tune in every Wednesday at 2 p.m. Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific on the SHR Media Network. Go to shrmedia.com. At Lid Radio, we fight for the truth, justice, and a good kosher T-bone. If you don't listen, Hillary Clinton might sneak into your bedroom in her house coat late at night and blame you for her election loss. It's the Lid Radio Show with Jeff Dunnitz.
It's your business diva here, Melanie Collette. I am inviting you to a front row seat as I discuss some of the most intriguing details of wealth and finance with today's movers and shakers in the world of business. Listen in and discover financial truths on a global, domestic, and household scale. Uncover topics that will impact your wallet today and in the future. Money Talk with Melanie airs Monday through Friday, 5 p.m. East, 2 p.m. West, right here on SHR Media and High Plains Pundit Talk Radio. You can't afford to miss it.
The new show on the SHR Media Network, Sackheads Against Tyranny, on shrmedia.com. Go there quick like a bunny, 11 p.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Pacific, every Wednesday, live and direct on the SHR Media Network, shrmedia.com. Be there.
Broadcasting behind enemy lines in occupied California, a mere 2 miles from the state capital, the bloviating Zeppelin's Berserk Bobcat Saloon Radio Show can be heard every Tuesday and Thursday night at 8 p.m. Pacific and 11 p.m. Eastern, only on the SHR Media Network. Go to shrmedia.com to listen. You can also watch on the SHR Media Facebook page and the SHR Media YouTube channel. No goldfish were abused in the making of this ad.
Hey girls, Carry Girl Gear is here. More and more women every day are concealed carrying, participating in competitive shooting, and getting firearms training. It's not a boys' club anymore, and we don't have to shop in their stores anymore either. Finally, a cool and unique clothing line just for women. Dope tees and hats for the patriotic concealed carry and 2A girl. So what are you waiting for? Go check out carrygirlgear.com today.
Conservative media done right. You're listening to the SHR Media Network.